Hi everyone, today's topic is knapsack problem. We are going to solve a knapsack problem by using a branch and bound technique. Let's see how to solve it. The problem can be stated as follows. If we have given n object and a knapsack in which the object I with weight W is to be placed. The knapsack capacity is always the capital W. Then the profit value that can be earned is value, that is V. The objective is to obtain filling of knapsack with maximum profit earned. We have to earn a maximum profit from it. What is the constraint? The knapsack capacity, capital W, should not get exceeded when we are placing the item to it. So let's start solving our problem. This is the problem given for us. We have a list of items 1 to 4. For each item, we have a corresponding weight and the value. This is the total capacity of the knapsack. So we will move to solving the problem. So first step we have to do, we have to calculate the value bar weight for each item. So item 1, the value is 40. The weight is 4, so value divided by weight, 40 divided by 4, the value will be 10. So next item 2, the value is 42, the weight is 7, 42 divided by 7, it will be 6. So item 3, the value is 25, the weight is 5, so 25 divided by 5, the value will be 5. So the last item, item 4, the value is 12, the weight is 3, so 12 divided by 3 will be 4. After calculating the value bar weight, we have to see whether we have to go for a upper bound or lower bound for building a tree. So when you have to go for a upper bound or a lower bound in a problem, if you want to get a maximum value from a problem, then you have to go for a upper bound calculation. When you want to obtain a minimum value from a problem, then you have to go for a lower bound calculation. Yes, here in knapsack we have to yield a maximum profit. So we will be going for a upper bound calculation. Now, while building a tree, we will be starting from the first node. Initially, the bag will not contain any item to it. So empty bag, so the weight will be small, W will be 0. V will be 0. We have to calculate the upper bound. The upper bound is calculated by using a formula. So upper bound is equal to small v plus capital W minus small w into V of I plus 1 divided by W of I plus 1. So what is small v? What is capital W? What is small w? V is nothing but the value of each item. In each iteration, the value will be differing. Based on our iteration value, we have to take the value and place it. So small w is nothing but the corresponding weight of each item. Capital W is capacity of the bag. It will never change till our problem getting solved. Yes. So we will be calculating our upper bound for the node 0. Initially we have not placed any item to a bag. So small v obviously it will be 0. Small w it does not have any weight to it. So it is small w will be 0. If you are placing the item only, we will be having your small v and small w value. So capital W will be capacity of the knapsack. It is 10. And now it is a 0th iteration. So I value will be 0. So 0 plus 1 V1. So W, I value 0 plus 1. So W1, V1 bar W1, the item 1's value bar weight. So it is 10. Now we will be calculating our upper bound for this by using these values. So small v, it is 0 plus capital W, it is 10. Minus small w, it is 0 into v1 bar w1, it is 10. So the value will be 100. We have to come and place it to a tree node. So it is upper bound for the 0th node is 100. Now we'll be proceeding by adding each item in each iteration. On left hand side, we'll be calculating a value by adding the items. In right hand side, we'll be calculating a value without adding an item. Because in ABAC, we may not place the item to E. So on left hand side, we'll be adding item and calculate. On right hand side, we'll be calculate based on without adding an item. So now initially in zeroth node, the bag does not have anything to it. Now we are placing a item 1 to it. We'll be calculating a node 1 calculation. See the node 1 calculation, computation at node 1. So what will be the value? V is node 1 calculation. So B is first item value is 40, so it is 40. W value is the corresponding weight, first item's weight, so it is 4. So capital W always will be 10. Now it is iteration 1, so I value will be 1. So V is I plus 1, it is 2v2 divided by W, 1 plus 1, so 2. So w2v2 divided by w2v2 divided by w2 is 6. So 6, you will be calculating your upper bound, it is 76. You will be common placing to the tree node. Yes, now we have done with the node 1 calculation. Now node 2 calculation without adding a item 1. So node 3, we have not added any item to it. Yes, node 2 calculation, we have not added any item to it. So value will be 0, W will be 0 because nothing is inside the bag. So capital W will be 10. So 1 plus 1, it is 2. W also 1 plus 1, 2. V2 divided by W2. The second item V bar W, it is 6. We will be calculating the upper bound. It is 60. We will be common placing to a node. Now to proceed to our next iteration, we have to compare this particular node and this particular node, which is a promising node, which is not a promising node. Now as per the Knapsack problem, we have to gain a maximum profit. So upper bound, we have to take a maximum value and proceed with it. 76 and 60 is compact, 76 is maximum. So we will be taking this as a promising node and this will be denoted as a non-promising node. Now we will be calculating by adding an item 2 on a left hand side and without adding item on the right hand side. Now we are adding an item to it. So the bag contains 1 and 2 item. The node 3 will have a calculation based on item 1 and item 2. See, when you are checking for W, so item 1 is 4, item 7 weight is 7. So 4 plus 7, it is 11. It is exceeding the capital W value. So you don't want to go for upper bound calculation at all. You will be stopping there and ignoring that particular node. Yes, next we will be calculating for without adding a item 2. So the node 4 calculation. So now the item present in a bag is only item 1. So the value will be 40. Item 1 only present in a bag, so it is 40. Weight will be 4. It is lesser than the capital W, so you will be calculating B3 calculation. V bar W, that is iteration 2, so I value will be 2 plus 1. W, it is 2 plus 1. V3 divided by W3, it is 5. Yes, now you will be calculating your upper bound based on the formula. The value is 70. Now 70 will be placed to the node. Comparing, already you don't have anything on the upper bound as a node 3. Now only you have this particular node, you will be proceeding based on this particular value. So this will be a non-promising node, this will be act as a promising node. You will be further adding the item 3 on the left hand side and right hand side without adding an item. So node 5 calculation. Note 5 calculation. Bag will contain first item and the third item. So first item value plus third item value, totally 65. Now first item weight and second item weight, so 4 plus 5 it is 9. It is lesser than the capital W, then I iteration is 3, so I value will be 3. So 3 plus 1 4, V4 divided by W4 it is 4. So the upper bound will be 69. Yes, 69 will be denoted here. After completing a node 5 calculation, we will be seeing a node 6 calculation. In node 6 calculation, see this particular part, only the item 1 is added to it. So the bag contain only the item 1. See the node 6 calculation. In node 6 calculation, only the item 1. So that corresponding value V will be 40, W will be 4. So capital W is 10. Yes, small W is smaller than the capital W. So we will be calculating V bar W. The iteration value is 3. So I value will be 3. So 3 plus 1, V4 divided by W4. So V4 divided by W4, the value is 4. Yes, we will be calculating the upper bound. After calculating the upper bound, the value will be come and placed to the node 6. So upper bound is 64. Now we have to make a comparison between these two nodes, 69 and 64, which is maximum 69. So we will be proceeding with that particular node that will be acting as the promising node, and this will be acting as a non-promising node. From the promising node we will be proceeding. So we will be having the node 7 calculation. Node 7 calculation is nothing but we will be having an item 1, item 3 and item 4 to 8. So node 7 calculation, yes, yes, node 7 calculation weight is 4 plus 5 plus 3. Yes, 4 plus 5 plus 3 it is 12. It is exceeding the capital W value, so we will not calculate the upper bound at all. Yes, we will be just away that we will be leaving the node as such. Now we will be calculating the node 8 without adding the item 4 to 8. Now in this particular part, 1 and 3 alone have been placed to the back. Yes, node 8 calculation. In node 8 calculation, the item present in the back is item 1 and 3. So 40 plus 25, it is 65. V value 65. Small W value is 4 plus 5, it is 9. It is smaller than the capital W, so we will be proceeding. Now see, V value iteration is 4, I equal to 4, so 4 plus 1 is 5, W also it is 4 plus 1 equal to 5, so V5 divided by W5. Do you have any item called 5? No. So for the last item you will not have a V bar W value, so you have to mention it as 0. So you will be calculating the upper bound and placing the value here. Yes, the upper bound is 65. Now see the path in which you have got the solution. So we are adding item 1 and without adding item 2 and with adding item 3 and without adding item 4. So the solution is by adding item 1 and item 3 we got the answer. So this is your solution. If you have any doubt, comment me. Thank you.